gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to have the opportunity to speak to all of you today. I wish it was in better circumstances and not under such an unprecedented and extraordinary time that we are going through. However, I am extremely grateful to AICTE for having created this opportunity for all of us to connect, to learn from each other, to get to know each other better, and to find ways to collaborate and explore best practices as we go forward. I think that's a great initiative, and once again, a big thank you. I'm Geetika Dayal, Executive Director, TIE Delhi NCR. And what I will do today is to quickly go through a little bit of presentation to share with you a little more about TIE, the organization I represent, and the Delhi NCR chapter that I look after, and to be able to share some thoughts about what we do and how perhaps it is of great importance and relevance in this time to be able to work closely with institutions of higher education and see how we can make the most of it to take our country forward. So with that little bit of introduction, over the last couple of decades, of course, TIE has been working in this area. So I will just like to take the opportunity to present something that we've put together here and be able to share it with you. Well, this of course is the session, and I hope I'm able to share enough information and knowledge that gives you a fair assessment and idea of the work that TIE does, and then for us to be able to brainstorm further on how we can collaborate and serve your needs better as well. TIE, of course, was born in 1992 in Silicon Valley. And the way it all started was that people from the Indian diaspora who had gone from here to the US struggled. I mean, they managed to create successful companies, particularly successful technology companies at that point of time. And they were at the airport actually waiting for Mr. Vittal from India to arrive in San Francisco, where they were going to have a meeting with him at that time. As luck would have it, Mr. Vittal's flight was delayed, and this group of Indian diaspora individuals got together and said, to pass the time, perhaps it's a good idea for us to have lunch together. And that at that lunch meeting, TIE was born, because they realized that while they had all been there and had struggled in their own different ways, the best way that they could all give back to society was by coming together to share their experiences, their contacts, as well as their resources, etc., and to mentor young entrepreneurs and younger generation who was then going from India to the US. At that time, way back in 1992, as you can well imagine, startups was not something that was, you know, thought of as a natural progression of someone's career. It was not in fashion at that time to be a startup. So this became a very valuable service for when they would get together, share their stories with each other, and be able to mentor and guide young entrepreneurs over there. This then started spreading from Silicon Valley to other parts of the US. And then it came to India in late 1999, early 2000, where Delhi, Mumbai, and Bangalore were the first three chapters that got established. Today, we have over 22 chapters of TIE in India, as well as 61 chapters globally in about 14 countries. So it's a fairly vast network, which has been established by entrepreneurs for entrepreneurs with the single-minded mission of fostering the next generation of leaders. The philosophy being that every single entrepreneur, successful entrepreneur, ends up creating multiple job opportunities. So the cycle of wealth creation, value creation, and economic development of a nation through the process of entrepreneurship is what we work on. And the pillars, the cornerstone of TIE for being able to deliver that is through mentoring, networking, knowledge sharing and education, incubation and funding. We have, of course, a large network of people all across the world. And as we move forward, We have Thai members that are spread across the world. Our members are divided into two categories. There is one category called charter members. These are members who are seasoned, successful entrepreneurs, investors, and industry leaders who have demonstrated success across their industry or their walk of life and are now willing and able to share their experience with the younger generation. We also have institutional members where corporates or institutes can be a part of the Thai network by being able to connect with the ecosystem here as well. Then there is a larger set of members who are aspiring or early stage entrepreneurs or service providers, people who are looking to connect with the network to be able to derive value and get assistance from them. We hold a large number of events. Close to 100 events are held at by the Delhi NCR chapter itself. And of course, globally, there are many more. These events would range from a 10 people roundtable brainstorming session right up to a 20,000 people format event. And I will take you through some of the programs that we do. Obviously, it has a very vast impact and reach because all our chapters, our members, and our partner networks with whom we work, whether it's incubators or other industry associations, come together and create a very, very robust ecosystem of people interested in entrepreneurship. And we try and create year-long engagement, which is in a very, very deep impact manner so that we are able to actually address the very needs of the entrepreneurs and aspiring entrepreneurs as they might require them. So like I said, the first chapter of Thai in India, one of them being Delhi, was started by Mr. Saurabh Srivastava. He is also a Padma Shri winner and he has been the founder of a very successful software company that got acquired by Zanza and is now known by the name of Soprasteria. He's also the co-founder of Indian Angel Network. He's been the NASSCOM chairman in the past as well. So very illustrious individual who has been an institution builder at the core of it. He has been the founder president of Thai Delhi and incubated the chapter here. We have been fortunate to be among the most vibrant and large chapters simply because of the passion and the the spirit of the individuals associated with Thai at the board level and the charter member level to be able to drive it forward and really create a thriving ecosystem in India, the result of which we are seeing now, where the startup and investor ecosystem has evolved so much more over the last few years. The way we work is that while Thai provides this basic core service of addressing the needs, bringing together aspiring and early stage and growth stage entrepreneurs, but to do that, we also engage closely with a large number of partners, many of them from the corporate sector, because they work closely and have a lot of value that they can provide to the startup ecosystem. So from different industries, technology companies, aviation industry, institutions, travel and technology companies, etc. We have a large network of corporates that we connect with. We also connect closely with the investor community, whether it is the angel investors or the VCPE industry, because once somebody starts a business, they do need to look out for funds. And at the same time, the investors are also looking for good deals that they can invest in, support, nurture, take forward, and be able to scale up with them. Banks, financial institutions, governments, both in India as well as overseas. So when we look at international collaboration, we try and work with governments where there is support for startups and to be able to nurture a cross-border exchange of ideas, investments, capital, and people as well to be able to expand markets. And within the country, we work closely with STPI, DST, Startup India under DPIIT, and with various state governments where we are working together to create a more vibrant startup ecosystem at the state level. We have, like I just mentioned, just a few numbers here. We have about 1,300 Thai members in Delhi NCR. over 175 angel investors and VCs connect with us. We have over 280 charter members, the individuals who are role models and mentors for young entrepreneurs. We are across a lot of industry segments as well. So we have special interest groups that we work with. While initially I started, there was a lot of focus on technology because we were born in Silicon Valley. But in India particularly, we have expanded across various special interest groups, which include healthcare, retail, food and food services, sports and fitness, education and training, travel sector, internet, mobile, clean tech. We have a special interest group for women entrepreneurs and social entrepreneurs as well. So that has been something that we have seen, especially in Delhi NCR, a large diversity of sectors that we have been able to focus and work with here as well. I think I should, may perhaps I haven't put it on full screen, so this I think may give you a better idea now. What we try and do is to be able to identify and nurture startups at a very, very early age, because we have found that the earlier that we are able to handhold and showcase them, the faster and more impactful is the success that they end up creating in the ecosystem. Some of the award programs that we run, the Tialumis Entrepreneurs Excellence Awards, Manufacturing, Spirit of Manufacturing Awards, TIQGLU Awards. We have a Tie the Knot, which is like a replica of Life Funding Platform. And we work with BIRAC to bring to you winner awards as well in the biotech and healthcare space. Startup Expo, Elevator Pitch, etc. The names that you will see as part of this Make My Trip, VLCC, Nolarity, Beer Cafe, Travel Khana. Many of these names have now gone on to become, you know, literally inspirational role model companies. But the success and the satisfaction that we derive has been the fact that we came close to them when they were very young companies. We awarded them, lauded their efforts. We were able to mentor them and stay connected to them in their journey as they grew. So that has had a deep impact. Just a quick look at some of the board members that are there in Tie Delhi NCR. We are currently led by our president, Rajan Anandan, who was still recently heading Google in India and Southeast Asia and is now an MD at Sequoia Capital. Saurabh Srivastav, like I mentioned, is our chairman emeritus of Tie Delhi NCR. Our past presidents also include Pramod Bhaseen, the founder of Genpact and Clix Capital, Deep Kalra, founder and group CEO of MakeMyTrip.com, Sanjeev Bichandani, vice chairman of Naukri.com, Mr. Pradeep Gupta, Chairman and Managing Director, Cyber Media Group, and basically a lot of people who are true believers of the startup ecosystem and have been extremely entrepreneurial, not only in what they have done in their careers, but how they have gone on to support a large number of startups as well as mentors, as well as investors. So we're very fortunate to have a board that is truly visionary and supportive in the work that they do. In terms of the programs that I was talking about, one of the largest format events that we do has been the Startup Expo. I hope some of you have had the opportunity to participate here. This has been in partnership with Lufthansa. And this is almost attended by 15 to 20,000 people, where we have a lot of young companies who are given a stall to showcase for free, and there we are able to create visibility and awareness and brand building for startups. We also hold investor sessions, so almost 1,000 investor meetings and pitches are held in one day. There are dedicated networking zones, mentoring zones. We hold sessions throughout the day under a Thai Institute program to educate young entrepreneurs, etc. So extremely exciting program that happens, that will now happen in February of next year. We hope many of you will have a chance to participate. It's free of cost, and it's a platform that brings together every single individual who has an interest in connecting with the startup community. and then they are able to come there and build their collaborations and partnerships. We also have a large program which is called TaiCon or the Thai Global Summit, the annual flagship event of a Thai chapter, where we have 2 days of inspirational keynotes, knowledge sharing, sessions which talk about trends in technology, trends in funding and various other aspects. And there a lot of other startups get a chance to pitch to investors, win awards. So really a sort of a mega mela of entrepreneurship and inspiration that happens at these programs. Apart from that, we have programs which we will now be taking a lot onto the virtual platform in terms of online summits that we will connect. This is the India Internet Day, the India Education Entrepreneurship Day, our Women Entrepreneurs Summit. We have a food summit, a healthcare summit, a retail summit, and a travel summit. And many of these are programs that happen every year. And this year, of course, we are now ramping up in terms of regular features through webinars and then lead up to the main annual conference as well. Apart from that, we do a lot of sessions which also help peer-to-peer engagement. Because while a mentoring format is great and people get to learn a lot because it's basically formed on the, you know, when Thai was established, it was established on the ancient Indian tradition of Guru Shishya model. But now we also have a lot of programs that we do which encourage peer-to-peer interaction and learning, because there's a lot of value that people derive in learning from their own peer network in terms of what happened in the recent past that they are able to relate with and learn from. There's a lot of emphasis now in those programs for peer-to-peer learning as well. We have a Thai Institute format, which has been physical sessions which pick up a specific topic and help in skill building of entrepreneurs, which has now been taken online. So thaiinstitute.in is the online platform for sessions and programs, what we have now, where people can access at the moment content. Right now it's free of cost, where they can go and learn in a specific on-demand module kind of a format. Multitude of formats of sessions, whether it is pitching sessions, whether it is mentoring, roundtables, knowledge series, a whole lot of things go on at Thai throughout the year. So obviously a very, very busy calendar of activities that we maintain through the year. And that is particularly because the startup community needs a lot of inputs, a lot of help, a lot of support and partnership opportunities. That's what we try and provide through the Thai programs. What we have done, of course, now is very quickly turned the model around. Part of it was already happening, but of course, this has given us the opportunity within this lockdown period to actually take our offering to a much larger audience base, which is not just limited to our city, but can be accessed by every corner of the country as well as the world, in fact. So from the very first day of the lockdown, which was on 23rd March, we have had a webinar every single day on specific topics that are of great relevance and emphasis for startups and aspiring startups to learn from, where they feel that they are not alone in this struggle or in this journey. And there is a lot for them to be able to learn from the experiences of those who have been through past recessions. Startups and entrepreneurs, of course, go through a lot of ups and downs, and it's a very lonely struggle for an individual. But having a network like Thai, where they can get a support system when they need it, as they need it for whatever problems they are facing, and a lot of inspiration, so that gives them the ability to persevere and to keep their confidence alive. So we've been taking a lot of our sessions online through webinars and conferences. We have opened out a mentoring helpline where anybody can write into us, and our senior charter members do one-on-one sessions with them to advise them. We've been getting inputs and advice from all across the world, and some of the corporates and investors, etc., also to share their experiences and learnings at this time. We are also supporting the Startup India platform and their portal by becoming national startup COVID advisors, where Ask Me Anything sessions or webinars are things that we are helping them put together on their platform. At the same time, startups can post their questions from anywhere across the world. The regulatory questions are, of course, answered by the Startup India team itself. But apart from that, if there are any business-related questions, then Tidally NCR is helping address those. So we've really sort of expanded beyond the geographical boundaries of our chapter. Basically, you know, just in terms of course, some of the people who have been associated with us, as I said, there is a reason why they connect with Thai, and that is because they get a great network of people who understand what challenges they have, what concerns they have, or what issues they might be facing, as a result of which they have been able to really get support when they needed it, get inspiration, get a network of advisors, which is why they have now become people who also give back. You know, it's something which is like a journey. When you benefit from something or someone, you tend to pass it on to the next person who comes to you. So this in a nutshell is, of course, what Thai Delhi NCR does. Of course, we will be very happy to answer any questions or respond to any queries that you may have. I've put out our numbers. You can write in to me at deepika@thainewdelhi.org. My number is here, 98105-39848. I'll repeat that, 98105-39848. Our website is delhi.thai.org. Apart from that, I will just sort of exit this presentation to just share a few other thoughts that I feel perhaps would be relevant. Because at any point of time, when we talk about success or we talk about an individual, it really needs an ecosystem for them to thrive, for them to survive and succeed. When you look at Silicon Valley and how it was created and what kind of impact it had on the entire area and built up a, mentor, investor, kind of a network there, it did not happen on its own. There was Stanford that played a key role as an academic institution of higher learning, which nurtured research, which nurtured technology, deep learning, which nurtured innovation and the culture of innovation and the mindset of entrepreneurship within their campus. There was Thai that started and supported it from an industry perspective. And that brought about that whole ecosystem of corporates, investors, academic institution, and network enablers to come together to build what was a Silicon Valley culture of entrepreneurship and angel investing. And that really is something that in India has been recognized as a need of the hour in terms of job creation, etc., especially when we talk of the demographic dividend, then harnessing it in the right manner is something that the government has recognized and created guidelines and opportunities, of course, and AICT is playing a remarkable role in enabling that. And all of you, in terms of the educational institutions that you run, are actually doing that. Where we come into the picture is, what we have is, of course, a great intellectual pool of people who have had real experience. So in terms of being able to provide opportunity for experiential learning, opportunity to provide access to mentors, network, and industry. We also work closely with incubators that are housed within academic institutions. So any support that is required there is another area that we have been working on. We have been collaborating with BIRAC and conducting workshops in different cities and different educational institutions to be able to create awareness and knowledge among the student community in terms of what it takes to be an entrepreneur, how to start up and equip them with the right kind of skills. We have also been partnering with the leading educational institutions in terms of putting together learning programs, whether it is Thai Young Entrepreneurs or Thai University, Thai Emerging Entrepreneurs, etc. So those are different programs where we understand the needs of the particular institution and design a program according to that. We are planning to launch two more things in the near future. One is a summer boot camp for students who are interested in entrepreneurship, so that we can deliver it online to them at this time when they really need that kind of learning, understanding, as well as opportunity to sit at home and get knowledge from the best of the best. Along with students, we are also great believers that a lot of skill, a lot of knowledge, and a lot of experience resides with the faculty members. So we are putting together a faculty development program that we hope to be able to deliver in the summer as well, where it will be about, of course, getting them into the entrepreneurship mindset. And they are the ones who are, in constant contact with and play great influencer role in the life of a student. So for them to be able to bring out their ideas, bring out their knowledge and skill and mindset in that sense is again something that we feel it's almost like a mentor the mentor or train the trainer program. So those are some of the key things that that we have been doing and we plan to do. If there is any way that we can be of assistance to you and your institution, please do reach out to us. We would be extremely keen to find ways to collaborate. I think you all are, really, you hold the key to the future of our country and future leaders. And we have never been faced with a more difficult situation or a more uncertain future at this point of time. But the only ones who will really pull us out of it, apart from our, healthcare workers, is a spirit of resilience, a spirit of entrepreneurship, out-of-the-box thinking, as well as innovation, which will now be required in every sphere of life. Because everything will now be different, whether it is about the way we work, the way we learn, the way we socialize and network, or the way we access education, medicine, and many other services that we are so used to. So the seed of innovation has to be sown and planted at an early age, but it has to see very rapid turnaround at this point of time because the country and the world needs it now more than ever. Thank you so much. I hope I have not taken too much time. And I will be open to interacting and connecting with all of you. A big thank you to AICTE once again. Stay safe, stay healthy, but stay connected, even if it is virtually. Thank you very much.